Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. And come on, do you have a backup for your website? I mean, look at your website, think about it. Do I have a backup, and where is that backup? Now, if your answer is no, you must be smoking crack or something, because you're crazy if you do not have a backup for your website, or if you think your web host has a backup for your website, you are sadly mistaken. You cannot trust your web host to have a backup. You have to have your own backup that is automated. It happens on a schedule. You have verified that it works, and it backs your website up off-site, so your backup is not sitting on your web hosting provider's server. All kinds of bad things happen in the internet, and websites get hacked into. You make mistakes. Hosting providers, they have problems. They have hardware failures. Everything gets wiped out. Even they think they have a backup, and sometimes those backups get corrupted. I have experienced, I have seen it all. And I just want you to not be a victim. I care about you enough to want you to not be a victim of any of this. And normally, I do not ask for you to share my video, but I'm asking you to share this video on your social networks, because I'm going to show you how to back up your WordPress-based website, and it's going to be automated, it's going to be off-site, and it's going to cost you nothing to do, and it's going to take 5 minutes to set up. So if that interests you, share this video on all your social networks. Give it a thumbs up right now. We want to make sure as many people see this as possible. Let's get started. So we're going to use the free plugin called Updrafts Plus. It is free. It's used on over a million WordPress-based websites, and I'm going to tell you, there's a lot of backup solutions. I've used them all, and this is the only one that I would trust to use to back up my website. I've even used some of the expensive paid backup plugins. One of them is called Backup Buddy. I don't know why anyone would use that thing. It is such a nightmare to actually restore your backup. There's so many failures in the backup process. This is the only backup solution I have found that can handle anything I throw at it. I've even used this to back up a website that was over 8 gigabytes in size, and Updrafts had no problem. It's the only plugin to backup that has never let me down, not once. And it has saved my butt more than once. Okay, enough of me talking. Let's just get it installed. So I've got this website right here. I'm going to go to plugins, add new. And then I'm going to do the search for Updrafts Plus right there. I'm going to click on install now. And then I'm going to click on activate. And there we go. So what this is going to do, it's going to add a new option here for settings, and it's Updrafts Plus. Now, they also have paid add-ons, and you don't need any of them to make a backup and restore backup and to do it off-site. You don't need any of these add-ons, so just know that right now. So first thing we want to do is go into settings, and we're going to set this up. So WordPress is a bunch of files and a database. Now, the files don't change that much. That's when you update WordPress. Update a theme or install a new plugin. Those are your files. But whenever you add a page or a post or get a comment, that is in your database. So we're going to have a different backup frequency for these two things. So for the files, they don't change that often. I want to automate backing that up once a week. And how many versions of it do you want to keep, whether it be 2 or 1? Let's just leave that as 2. So that means if you have 2 backups already from the last 2 weeks and it goes to make a new backup, it's going to delete the oldest backup. That's all that means. Okay, so now for the database backup schedule, this is important. You want to do this every single day, and you'll thank me later. So, and for this, we want to retain more. Now, your database isn't going to be so huge, the backup. So we can either go to 7 or 14 on this. If you really wanted to be safe, do 14. I usually do 7, but it's completely up to you, the frequency. So that's the first step. Now, the next step is right here. We need to choose which remote storage solution that we want to use to store this backup on. Remember, you got to have your backup off site. Now, I use Dropbox. I'll have a link down below. I think if you use my link, I get an extra, some extra storage capacity and you get some extra storage capacity, or you probably already have a Dropbox account. That's fine too. Now, there's other services here that are supported. I use Dropbox. It's been super reliable. And here's the thing, Dropbox actually keeps a file that you might delete for 30 days. So even though this automated process might delete off your old backups, you'll still have access to the prior 30 days beyond that of backups that Dropbox does for you. And Dropbox gives you 2 gigabytes for free, so there's no cost to have Dropbox. You might already have it. And then when you like refer people to Dropbox, they'll give you an extra 250 megabytes. I know for me, I have over 11 gigabytes of Dropbox storage. I think it's fantastic. So I'm recommending you use Dropbox. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Dropbox. Now, the way it works is, here's some instructions. I'm going to go down and click on the save button, and then I have to authenticate the Dropbox to allow Updrafts to make its backups there. It's super simple. So right here is the files to include in the backup. We're going to leave these all checked. And the way it works is Updrafts creates different archive files to make up your backup. So it takes all of your themes and it zips them all together, and that's one part of the backup. It takes all your plugins, zips them, that's another part of your backup. Your media library, which is going to be the biggest of all these files, it zips all those and puts that, and it does the same thing for your database. So it's going to have them all separated out like that, which is more efficient if you ask me, and it's more convenient because I might just want to restore a plugin, or I might just want to store my theme. So that's when you might do a theme update and it breaks everything and you want to go back. That's where just restoring your themes is very convenient. So we'll leave all that. Database encryption, that's a paid add-on and we don't need it anyway. Email notifications, you can turn that on. I don't. It will get too annoying for me. And then there's some expert settings, but I'm going to go ahead and click on save changes. Now it's going to give me this notice that I need to now click on this link and make that connection between Updrafts and Dropbox. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it. And now it's taking me over to Dropbox. You can see by the Dropbox logo, I'm on Dropbox's website. And right now it's asking me to log into my Dropbox account. So I'm going to go ahead and log into my Dropbox account. But if you don't already have one, you might want to do that first. You might want to create your Dropbox account first. Or right here it says new to Dropbox, create an account. It's all up to you which order you want to do it. So I'm going to log in now. Okay, now that I am logged in, it's taking me to this screen right here where all I have to do is click on this button here that says complete setup. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this, and then it's going to put me right back into my WordPress website, and it's going to give me some stats on my Dropbox account. So that will further confirm to you that it's made the connection. It lets you know how much of your storage capacity you've used and how much you have available. Now, you technically don't even have to do anything right now. It'll just automatically make a backup according to that schedule, but it's probably a good idea to click on the backup now button, and this will make your first backup, and it'll be a manual backup, but then it's going to make those automated ones moving forward. Now, whenever you click on that button, it's going to give you these options right here, and just leave them all checked. It's basically saying, do you want to back everything up? And then do you want to send this off to your remote storage, which in this case is Dropbox. So I'm going to go ahead and click on backup now, and you're going to see right here, it's making the backup files and it's already pushing them off to the remote storage. Now, this WordPress website is not that big, and so this backup is going to go pretty fast. And right now you can see it's uploading those files right now. 20%, 40%. It's already on file 2 of 5. And then I'm going to show you what we do to restore it. It should be done any moment here. Okay, and we're at 100%, file 5 of 5. So now my backup's done. Now, if you have a website with lots of images and plugins and themes, that backup might take a few minutes. And so you could just go and then come right back. But anyways, I'm going to now click on existing backups, and you can see I've got this backup right here. Now, if I wanted to download this to my local computer, I can click on any of these buttons here and download that to my local computer if I wanted to. And over time, you're going to start having all these lists of your backups here and the date that you made it. You can click on restore and it will restore any of these old backups that you have. And when you restore, you can choose to just restore the themes or just restore the plugins or just restore the database or just restore the uploads. You can choose what you want to restore. And that's why this is so powerful. There's so many times where people will either update their theme and it breaks things or update a plugin and then regret it and want to go back. You can easily do that here. Now, it doesn't let you choose the exact plugin. It'll just restore all the plugins that you had based upon the date that you made that backup. Now, if disaster strikes and your whole website is wiped out and you want to restore it, all you have to do is install a fresh installation of WordPress, then install Updrafts, come here and click on Upload Backup Files. So you would then just go and download it from Dropbox. You'd go here, click on Upload Backup Files, upload them in, and then click on Restore that way. And that's how you would restore your website if some disaster struck and maybe it got hacked into, or maybe your web hosting provider left you out in the dust. So this is all there is to making a backup, guys. It doesn't cost anything. It's going to be fully automated from here on out. I would hate for you to be a victim and to have this huge cost and penalty if something bad happened to your website or your web hosting provider. Don't trust your web hosting provider. Even if you have the best, most expensive web hosting service, don't trust them. You cannot trust them to back up your website. And I've seen enough situations where the web host really let you down. You can't trust them with it. You have to have your own backup solution. And this is it. It's free, guys. Take this video, share it on your social networks. Hey, if you consider yourself a friend to someone else, make sure they have a backup of their website. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you.